top news headlines from the news desk at the Kittanning Paper right now on Radio for Your Neighborhood. AM 1380 and FM 103.7. WTYM, Kittanning, Ford City.
Steve, tell me a little bit about the paintings that you have here today.
This is from the original photograph of the December the 19th, 1907, Dara Mine explosion. This is the rescue team that went in. The first one, two, three, four guys, what they call farriers, they take care of the mules, and you can see they're getting ready, shoeing up and everything to get in there. They get recover those 325 bodies out of there. That's how many were in there. And these guys are the coal miners, and this is the boss.
Now, how long did it take you to paint this?
That took me about a month and a half to paint that.
Okay.
Yeah. And this is the Pittsburgh coal, Dara Mine, owned by Mr. Mellon family. That's who owned the coal mine. And it blew up 6 days before Christmas.
Now, this isn't the only painting that you've done on this particular subject, right?
I did this one here, which is, I guess what they're doing here that day and is posing to show that this was Pittsburgh coal's most modern mine. They had made their own electricity there in 1907, and this is their coal boring machine that they had there. And they were posing to show that they were they had the latest technology, but it was one of the Pittsburgh coal most modern mines, but at the same time the most gaseous mine. And the accumulation of coal dust and criminal negligence on the part of the company, which is common in those days when they valued the life of a mule more than a miner. The price of coal shot up December the 19th, and they told him to go back in. And the union says it was a union mine. Over 325 miners went in that day. They have it. Hallopy, the district rep, said that's how many men went in that day. But the official count is 239. But nobody really knows how many people were killed in it. It's the largest coal mine explosion in Pennsylvania and the second largest in the United States.
And this captured your attention. Why?
Because this is my hometown. My family were all coal miners, and I'm a steel worker. And this kind of thing was suppressed when you grew up. You knew it happened, but nobody talked about it. It was only a sort of secret amongst the miners, you know. And
so this is your way of memorializing them?
Yes, and they have nothing down there. They have no memorial on that site, that coal mine. So they just recently sealed it about 2 years ago. It was open. I've gone in that mine. You could go in that mine. All they did was over here was piled up dirt, pushed dirt over that. And it was all open here. You could just go right down there and go back. I've been in there 400 feet, but they recently sealed it up with more dirt. You know.
Well, that would be kind of dangerous today as well. Yeah.
Yeah, but there's nothing here at this site. Nothing. Not one thing.
I'm captured by this one. This is
this is Brownsville, Pennsylvania. Brownsville, Pennsylvania. This bridge doesn't exist anymore. It's called the Dunlap Creek Bridge. That's the Dunlap Creek. This is how people got downtown Brownsville. To get to work, probably about, this is early 1900s, and they braised this bridge to the ground, but you can see the craftsmen, the workmanship that went in that bridge. I worked this from a black and white photograph that was taken, and I've got it on the internet and found that there. And Brownsville, we've all heard what happened there, right? There's nothing there anymore. All the braised, everything is just tore up. There's nothing there. It's like an industrial, it's just a wasteland there.
Because?
The collapse of the steel industry and coal industry and the boat building was in Brownsville. They built boats, barges, to move coal. And it's a ghost town now.
So many of these have to deal with the steel industry, the coal industry.
Yes, the industrial base of Pennsylvania, southwestern Pennsylvania, that doesn't exist anymore. Mm-hmm. You know, and this one here is U.S. Steel. This is the U.S. Steel plant in Duquesne. This is the ore bridge that took the coke and the iron ore and loaded it up in skips up into the furnace and made cast iron. And they took this cast iron and made steel and added carbon to it and made steel out of it. But this place has been brazed to the ground here, the U.S. steel plant in Duquesne. And this painting here is a modern painting. This is of a continuous caster. And I purchased the photograph from an electrician who was working in a plant close to Cleveland somewhere. And he had been walking by, and the bottom of the ladle washed out of that wash that and blew out on the floor. And they lost all the steel that was in there. Because this is six stories to the top of the crane. He's lifting it up to take it into the caster and let it run into the caster to cast slabs, steel slabs. But the washout hole blew out, and he lost all probably 300 ton of molten steel that went on the steel floor. Extremely dangerous. And this is the U.S. Steel, but this is the Hot Metal Bridge in Pittsburgh, J&L Steel. This is a study that I was doing of Otto Kuhler. Otto Kuhler did this original painting, I think, in 1890 of the steel mill, and I liked it so much, I couldn't afford it. You're talking hundreds of thousands of dollars for the painting, so I tried to do it in my style, one of his paintings.
Now, speaking of your style, this is so captivating when you see it. It's unique. I mean, I'm not into painting enough to know what the style is, but what do you call your style? Do you have a name for it, or it's just a
hoop? No, I never thought.
You just do it because that's what you're talented to do.
That's just what I do, Just the way it comes out. I think it has something to do with my background in the steel industry, and I've always been attracted to, and I've always hated the fact that they shut down the steel industry and wiped out 125,000 jobs in the Pittsburgh area.
And now you also spend some time in military.
Yes.
So you have people here that are here from Meckling is here.
They're all my friends. They come down. They came down to, I called them up, and they always come to support me,
Now, where were you at when you served?
I was in the U.S. Army. Okay. 1960. I was drafted in 69.
Okay. So you were in Vietnam.
Vietnam era.
So could you say this is somewhat, in some respects, therapeutic?
Oh, yeah. It's like therapy painting.
Yeah.
When you sit down and you work on a canvas, it's therapeutic. It definitely is. It makes you... But also it makes you angry, too, because you know what was there.
Yeah.
Previously, and the jobs and everything were there, and the power of American capitalism and the heyday of American capitalism, and now it's gone.
And what's your next painting you're going to work on?
I haven't decided yet. But I think since I'm here living in Kittanning, it should be something of Kittanning. If I could get some good photographs of the interior of Pittsburgh, that's the only place where they have PPG plant over there. I've been looking for some good photographs to work from, but high quality, but I haven't been able to secure any photographs yet.
I've got a few from Alger before they shut it down.
That might be good. So, I have to look at that.
All right. Thank you, Steve.
I appreciate this.
WTYM, Kittanning, Fort City, on the radio at AM 1380 and FM 103.7, and online at WTYMradio.com. Radio, computer, or smartphone. Stay connected to radio for your neighborhood.